Hey guys, this is Abhishek from gadgetjuice.com, and today we are here at the Fly Mobile event, and we have a new affordable smartphone which has been launched today. This is going to be available on snapdeal.com. You can buy this phone for a price of 5999. It comes with Android 4.4.2 KitKat preloaded, and it has a 1.7 GHz octa-core CPU, which is MediaTek 6592, which is a very good thing as far as hardware is concerned. We have 8GB of internal storage, 1GB of RAM, 5MP fixed focus front camera, and the rear camera is 8MP autofocus. It can record high definition video from the rear camera. It does have LED flash as well. We have these buttons over there, power and sleep key, which is a plastic button, gives you a decent amount of feedback. On this side, we have the volume rocker, which is also a plastic button finished in chrome, which also looks very nice. As far as the top is concerned, we have a 3.5 mm audio jack. At the bottom, we have the micro USB port for data syncing and charging. We have another thing over there, which I'm not sure what it is for, but we will confirm that later. And the back cover can be removed. You have a loudspeaker over there. At the back side, we have the Fly branding. On the front, we can see that we have nice metallic earpiece below the glass. And over here, we have touch capacitive buttons, which do have backlit LED. So they do have backlit LED. That means they have not done the compromise as far as the backlit LED lights are concerned, especially for a budget phone like this. As far as overall specification goes, this looks like a very good phone. And in terms of the overall design, this looks very nice. It is kind of slim phone, very good to hold. It has a matte finish back cover, which again can be removed and the battery can come out. The battery inside is a 2000 mAh battery. And again, it can give you around 1 day of battery backup easily as per the information which we have got. You have Mali 450 GPU, which is clocked at 600 MHz, so you have a very good hardware specification coming on this phone. Let's take a look over the phone dialer. So this is how the phone dialer look like. You can easily dial the number, and you can also make a cellular video call on this phone, which is good. We have messaging application over there. Let's take a look over the keyboard. And again, the keyboard is kind of stock Android. Again, it does not have continuous input typing supported. Swipe to type is not supported. But the keys are pretty big in size, and you can easily type on this device. And you can always type in the landscape mode as well, in case you face any issues. Let's take a look over the settings. And for that, we will go over here. When it comes to the automatic brightness support, it does have that. Automatic brightness is supported. And let's take a look over the version of Android and other details. So we have Android for KitKat 4.4.2. We have wireless update, that means system updates will be there on this phone. OTA updates is something which you can get on this one. However, Lollipop update is very unlikely to get to be there on this one. We have the support to change the default brightness, so you can change the default brightness from the phone memory to the SD card. And here we have the storage. We have 8GB of internal storage. Out of that, 1.14GB is allocated for the applications, and rest of it is available for the user. Again, this is the SD card as of now, which is 8GB inserted. So again, when it comes to storage, the storage is going to be something which you will get on this phone, approximately 5GB. So 5GB is something you will get on the phone storage area. However, 1.14GB is allocated for application on that one. So the internal storage of the phone is actually divided, and the SD card which is inserted inside is 7.45GB, which is again something which you will have to buy it on your own, because it will not come within the package. Let's take a look over the RAM. We have 1GB of RAM on this device, and I will show you the current scenario for the RAM as well. Okay, it has loaded. So out of 1GB of RAM, approximately 631 MB of RAM is free, which is making this device pretty responsive, and there is no issue at all as far as the overall UI is concerned. We have support for tethering as well. You can create a portable Wi-Fi hotspot on this phone. You have support for USB tethering, and Bluetooth tethering is also supported. Let me just come back and show you some more details. You do have support for GPS navigation as well. Again, we are not sure about the sensors, but GPS navigation will work on this device as per the information which we have got. Let me just take a photo as of now from this device and show you the same. So as far as the rear camera is concerned, the rear camera is good, and it can record high definition video. However, you need to keep your hand stable in order to take a very good photo. So we have just taken the photo. This is how it looks like. I would say the photo is looking pretty decent for a low light photo which has been just taken. Details are not that great, but you can take very good photos if you hold the phone stable. You do have support for HDR mode as well. So HDR mode is also supported on this phone, in case you can see that. And let's take a look over the front camera, and we will take a photo from the front camera as well. Again, I don't have my tripod. That is why the video might be shaking, might be a shaky thing for you actually. So let me just take a photo as of now. So I've just taken the photo, and this is how the front camera selfie look like. The front camera selfie is looking pretty decent. I would say it is not bad. The 5MP camera is doing a pretty good job. However, details are not that clear. So don't expect very good amount of details in the front camera selfies unless you are taking a photo in a daylight scenario. Here we have the rear back cover open, and as you can see, this is a dual SIM phone. You can insert two SIM cards, one on the top of other, and we have a micro USB memory card slot as well to expand the storage. And the battery inside is a 2200 mAh battery, and this is the loudspeaker which we have on this phone, which is fairly loud. Again, not too loud and not too less as well in terms of the overall sound. So that's all from us. Do let us know if you have any specific question for this device. We would love to help you. You can like this video help you by clicking the like button below. You can subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.